I literally look like the president right now. Hey everyone, hello old sports, hello newcomers that have recently subscribed to my channel. I'm happy to see everyone. And today I'm going to tell you about my language goals for the upcoming 2021. I hope that they will motivate you, or at least you'll just enjoy hearing about my plans for the future. I think that I'm going to update you on my goals on my Instagram throughout the year. Los Gates. So the first language I'm going to talk about is English. English has integrated into my life very long ago in my childhood, and I guess that it has become the part of my life, or literally my life, my profession, my hobby. I face with English every day, and I guess that I speak it quite fluently. But at the same time, there are lots of things that I still don't know. And moreover, I have no proof of my current level of English that I perceive as C1 or something. And that's why the first goal would be taking an IELTS exam, because it's quite important. And not only just to prove myself that I have such a high level of English, but also for something else. But let's keep it a secret. In general, I would like to immerse myself more often into English culture, so watch more films, more TV series in English. Not everyone knows, but I have really poor reading skills in English, so that's why the next goal is to read at least one book in English, fully in English. And that's like, you know, in a short term. But in the long term, if I really get into this, who knows, maybe I will read more. Well, in general, with English it's quite easy. I just need to communicate with natives, immerse myself into the language, and take an exam, like, that's it. The next language is German. The first goal for German is to take a B2 exam in order to prove myself that I have this level of German, I really have it, and also for some further purposes, but I'm not going to talk about it right now. Read a book in German, because my reading skills suck in any language. But what's interesting is that my whole life has been connected with English, not with German, but my German skills are a bit better. I don't know how it works actually, but that's the reality. In German, I just want to be more fluent, I want to speak better. For this, I've set another goal, and it's to take italki lessons with native speakers. Of course, I communicate with native speakers on a daily basis, and I try to enhance my German. It's not the same if I, for instance, take the real lesson with a native speaker, so it's a bit different. So I would like to start with italki. So for German, it's immersion, B2 exam, italki lessons, reading. Reading is like my prime perspective, but I also would like to watch more German films or TV series to integrate more into German culture, to learn more about the history and the country itself. So there are lots of other things that I would like to do with German. We are coming further, and that's Spanish. With Spanish, I have kind of a love and hate relationship. In February, I'm going to finish my A2 course, so it's a bit perplexed with my plans for Spanish. So just continue learning new vocabulary. Then I also will try to memorize everything that I've learned for this 3 months of studying German at this course. So as for now, I have a really bad but at least A2 level in Spanish, and I wish that at least these basic things that I've learned and absorbed will stay with me, and my Spanish won't get worse. With my Spanish, I will try to reach at least B1 level. It'll take a lot of effort, it's not that easy as it may seem, but still, I'll try my best to get further with my Spanish in order not to forget it and stuff. I will try to love Spanish more this year. Some of you might know that this year I've dabbled into Korean a little bit, but I've stuck with it. As for now, I don't feel like continue learning this language, because I do have several languages with the beginning level. It's not really wise to start another language, because you won't benefit from it. You won't be able to master your previous target languages, and you won't be able to focus on this one, like, I mean, new language. You will spend all your time and effort on your main target languages, and so it would be like the complete mess. So that's why I guess it's not the right time for me to start off with Korean yet, because it's a bit different. Well, I guess it's a bit different from all the European languages, obviously, and that's why I don't feel like it. I feel like it's quite a great challenge and I'm not ready for that yet. About new languages, the one that I would really love to start learning seriously is Norwegian. Norwegian is a really interesting story because I started dabbling in Norwegian as well in 2020. I kind of even succeeded in it. It was spring, it was the time when I had to write my coursework for the university. I had no time literally, and that's why I stopped with it. Instead of dabbling, I would like to seriously start learning this language. And more than that, I have a friend from Norway, and I really hope that he's going to help me, so hey Martin. And for German, I have also one long-term longe. And for German, I have also one long-term goal, and that's if I successfully pass B2 exam, I would like to try taking C1. That sounds a bit insane. At least for now. German is basically everything for me. Can you just imagine that I've been learning English all my whole life and only like 20 years later I'll take this C1 exam? And as for German, it's been like a little bit more than a year. Well, at that time it would be like 2 years. 2 years later, only 2 years later, I'll take C1 exam. I guess it's kind of a really great result. And if I'll be able to do that, I'll be really proud of myself, I guess. We're coming to the most interesting part, and that's my channel here, because it's connected with languages. I would like to develop my channel and reach at least 500 followers, 500 subscribers on my channel. I know that it's not a great number of people, it's not that like huge, but still it would mean a lot to me, like 500 people watching my videos. Can you imagine? I cannot right now, but still, that's my goal, 500 subscribers. My minimum number of videos I should shoot the next year is 20 videos for 2021. Well, I guess I should make it 21. So yeah, 21 videos for 2021. The next aspect is italki. I would like to add that my plan for 2021 is to start teaching Russian. I've been really enjoying this process when you explain foreigners something about your mother tongue. I don't feel like teaching English, but with Russian it's absolutely new and unknown experience. As long as I have enough courage, because I have this stupid phobias and these stupid, absolutely stupid fears, and as long as I'm brave enough to overcome them, I'll be really happy to introduce you to my italki page. If there are any subscribers of mine that would like to learn Russian, so you're welcome, and I'll be waiting for you. Exactly for you. That's pretty much it. I guess these are my goals for 2021. If we all survive, we'll see whether I've accomplished them. Thank you so much for watching. I wish you a happy new year, enjoyable holidays, stay safe, stay tuned. Don't forget to put a like on this video. Write in the comments below what are your language plans, or just in general, your goals for the upcoming year. I hope to see you soon. Bye!